Welcome to the best thing since the best thing since sliced bread, and welcome to PTV. I am the host with the most British, like a roasted P to the white, to the R, to the O, and I'm surrounded by a plethora of people. So I'll just go based on my screen clockwise. I've got a wild Tommy. Say hello, Tommy.
Hello, Tommy.
I've got a Johnny, the co-host from the West Coast. Say hello, Johnny.
Yo!
I've got a plug-in Dave. Say hello, Dave.
Hello.
I've got a Leroy. Say hello, Leroy. Lee Rastabell.
Hello, Leroy.
And we've got an Artex. Say what up, Artex.
Artex. What's going on?
There he is.
I just realised that's a good t-shirt.
So, welcome to the chaos that is us trying to figure out how to record a Zoom game show, aka the King of the Nerds. What I have done is I've taken a bunch of random party games and given them a pop culture twist. And we're going to do some cheers and have some fun, and laughs and japes will be abound. Specifically, the first game is based on articulate. So I'll give you a prompt that I will DM to you, and you have to articulate that prompt without using the words in the prompt. But this game is called What Caveman Say Do. So you can only use single syllable words.
Okay. Right.
So I don't know if your prompt was Goku punch Vegeta, boy hit small boy. I don't know. Can't say monkey, that's already two syllables. You get the point. You know, Superman saves the day, blue man fly good.
Is a letter classed as one syllable?
Not W.
Very clever, and that's why Tommy's here. Right. So.
Wuh.
Wuh.
Phonetic.
Wow. I am going to send this prompt to one of you. So if I do that, and I do that, and I send that, in theory, only Johnny gets it.
Okay. Wow. Okay.
So I'm hoping none of the rest of you have seen that message.
I haven't received anything.
No. Cool. Good. I need some honor amongst thieves in this. All right, Johnny, you've had your prompt.
Is it this one that says Moby Dick?
Yes, it is.
Okay.
Top points to touch.
I mean, Will slaps Chris.
Well, no, because you can't use any of the words from the prompt.
I can't use any of the words from the prompt. Okay. I see.
Is it the Oscars? It might be the Oscars.
You know what, right? No, fuck it. I'm a generous and benevolent host.
I said it first, Dave.
I'll give it 2 points.
I feel like Will slaps Chris is acceptable, right?
Yeah, I mean,
big black man hits small black man on TV.
TV's two syllables. TV.
Will slaps Chris is way better than that.
Yeah, but you can't use the words that are in the prompt.
Man, on
prize show.
Yeah, exactly.
On show.
Right, Dave, do you see something now?
Yeah.
Okay. Articulate.
This is tricky.
This needs a timer.
Yeah.
No. You got all the time in the world, but you can't use the words from the
face. Face.
That's not all night.
Face hair. Hug man grabs big hug man at big hug show.
Oh, the YMCA.
Close.
Something about wrestling.
Yeah, am I allowed to say something about wrestling is close?
It is close.
I imagine it has something to do with face hair man.
Face hair man, big hug man.
I want to say I can't figure out face hug.
Well known.
I'm thinking something about the big show, potentially, but
think more big.
Think more big.
Those are single syllable words. Under
the giant.
Well, Kong. Yeah. One of the names got said. It was Artex.
Artex is closing in.
What do you want me to repeat it?
What did you say?
I said Andre the Giant.
All right. Well,
yeah. How do we confirm? Do they have to get the exact
Hulk Hogan
prompt?
Versus Andre the Giant?
Boom! That's got to be close enough, right?
That's close enough. Yeah, yeah. Points
yeah,
to
WrestleMania was added. That was the big hug show.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. If you can figure out how to do at WrestleMania,
big hug shows, WrestleMania. Yeah, yeah.
All right, cool. This is working. This is stuff.
Big hug show.
Big hug show. That's what I'm going to call wrestling from now on. You watch a big hug show this weekend?
You're going to love that big hug show. Good lord, man.
Big hug show 29.
Let's send this to Tommy.
He's sitting right next to me. Just turn the screen.
I mean, I could, but I've done it now.
All right, hang on.
I've also lost my pen. There it is.
Did you send it to
him? I did. You know what? He's right. I could just show you the screen.
Yeah.
All right.
Don't look at the other questions.
Oh no, I've already moved that screen.
Okay, cool. Old film men use big lass. Big green lass.
Pass.
Lass.
As in like
men
woman.
Men use big green lass. Men Do use you know? Big green lass. Four kill.
He's doing well.
Dead.
I like it.
Ooh. The last one. Is that the last word? Ooh. Ooh. No, just ooh. It's one syllable.
Yeah, ooh's one
kill
syllable.
Dead ooh. Four kill dead ooh.
Yep.
green woman. Is that Lass She-Hulk? As in woman.
Yep, yep.
More big green woman than Hulk.
More big. The Girl. Sweet corn woman.
She-Hulk.
More big.
More big.
Big.
More big,
big
than She-Hulk.
Friendly giant's girlfriend.
More big woman is free. Has woman. Torch.
Oh.
Has torch.
Statue of Liberty.
Oh, Ghostbusters 2.
There nice. You go. Points to Johnny.
Yeah, I think thanks. I deserve a fucking medal for that.
You know what, right?
That was great.
You know what? Fuck it.
Big green lass. That was good.
I'm gonna switch up the prompts, right? You get a point for dictating and for guessing. So
yeah,
far,
I like that.
Dave's dictated, and Johnny guessed, yeah. And then Tommy dictated and guessed. And then,
but
right.
I didn't get a point for the first one because I didn't dictate.
Yeah, yeah,
right,
yeah,
and I messed
yeah,
up the. Yeah, yeah, fine. Yeah.
Okay.
If no one guesses it, do you still get a point for describing?
No. You have to be able to articulate your
okay,
thing.
Okay, gotcha. I think face, big green face. Lass is a wonderful description.
That's what we call her.
That is what we call her.
And the big green lass out in the
big green
water.
Lass. Big green lass.
The big green lass of free.
Tex.
The green lass of free.
There you go, Tex. Have a prompt.
Right, and where's this going to
Here. Ah, in chat. Chat. Yeah.
Gotcha. Yeah. Gotcha. Let's have a look. We'll have to say like names of people.
You can't obviously use the names of or the words from the prompt.
And you can't use the names of the people to do with it.
I mean, the names of the people to do with are in the prompt, so no, you can't use the names that are in the prompt.
Well, they are, but they're not, if you get me. I think you know what I'm trying to say.
All of the things that I'm thinking you're thinking of are in the prompt, so if it's in the prompt, you can't say it.
I just look where you were looking, so I know what it is. Yeah. So I'm just jumping out of this.
Tommy's going to exempt himself from this round.
Okay.
It was really tempting to scream like Area 51 straight away. But I'm staying out.
Flying...
Well, that's two syllables already, so...
Oh, yeah. Crap. Wow, I did good already. Red fly. red fly.
Star Wars: The Death Star Run. Something. Let's
go. I'm trying to think of anything else, but I'm trying
the
to
red arrows.
One syllable.
The red wings.
Red Baron.
Tuskegee Airmen.
More words, Tex. Red fly yeah, man.
Red fly man.
Iron
yeah,
man.
I can't
Iron
say
man.
That, can I? Yeah. It's in the prompt. There's a little clue for you. Red fly Okay, well, just because Pyro said it, I'm going to say man. Red fly, man. Red fly, man, wife.
Red fly, Pepper man, Potts. Wife.
Red fly, man, girl, wife.
Girl, ooh, wife. It's not Pepper Potts.
I'll tell you what, I'm going to steal this prompt from you and give you another one because I know I can do this in single syllable words that people get.
I don't. All right. You don't know how to articulate right. that.
Red fly man, girl, wife.
I mean, that's not far off. Red fly man, tell girl he fly man.
Spider-Man tells Mary Jane he's Spider-Man.
I wouldn't have gone with red.
Ooh.
Red and blue fly man. Tell girl he fly man.
Is this Spider-Man? Right? Fly man? Because he was inspired by a
Spider-Man
fly.
Fly though. Does Spider-Man fly? That's.
I think it's Superman.
No, but he was inspired by a fly. Right? That's why he exists. Stan Lee saw a fly crawling on the wall.
I'm reasonably certain it's Superman, guys. Spider-Man doesn't fly.
Spider-Man
doesn't fly. He is a bug.
So Johnny, let's follow your line of articulation.
Is it Superman telling Lois Lane that he's Superman?
Oh, yeah. Fucking Dave.
There you go.
And more importantly...
I don't know why Johnny didn't just take the point.
I don't know why Johnny didn't take the point. But more importantly, points to me. Let's get just keep going with single syllable words until someone starts getting it.
Is it Spider-Man?
Mm-hmm. No, you're right, Dave.
It's Spider-Man.
They have both done that. They're both blue and red.
Yes, they
and
have.
And Spider-Man was inspired by a fly.
I swear you said Mary Jane.
No one said Mary Jane.
Someone said
girl.
Girl.
Mary and Jane
girl
are
wife.
Two words. Mary, Jane.
You know
Mary.
What?
Mary is two.
Mary!
I think Leroy needs to do a prompt.
Leroy's. Leroy,
are you giving me that now?
I'm sending a prompt to
bug up side. Down.
It's a cheat code for GTA.
It's a Konami code.
I'll allow it. Keep going.
Yeah, are you sure?
Yeah, why not?
I mean, I realise I just used like two of the words that are in the prompt.
You upside did. Down. Yeah,
Spider-Man's upside down kiss with Mary Jane.
Hey, Johnny.
I like you did it like bug upside down to make it seem like you weren't doing that. You might as well just said kiss.
Bug up. Oh, yeah.
But I did up and side as in two different words. So.
Bug upside down kiss.
All right, yeah, so we've gone round the rounds once. Everyone gets how it's working. We're liking how the game's working. Do we want to go around one more time?
It's up to you, mate.
Let's go around again. All right, let's go around again.
Now that we understand how the game works.
I did one. I stole. In fact, because I stole this one from Tex, I'm going to give Tex that one, and then this will end the first round of prompts. And then we'll go around one more time, because this is a laugh. But this time, buzz in, and I'm going to get a bit more strict. If you hit a double syllable word, that's it. That's the end of your talking.
And
they have to guess.
No.
But everyone else just has to guess based on what you said up to the point you hit a double syllable. You've sent one to me.
Sabotage everyone. Basically,
you sent one to me. Hold on, chat. More than one girl in round thing.
Two girls, one cup.
That's what I was gonna go with.
I can't believe you included that. Oh wow, I thought I was doing a joke.
This is supposed to be a children's show.
Lucky for me, we can edit around this.
Now that should stay in.
Oh, brilliant. There you go, Artex. Articulate that. Buzz in when you know what you're chatting about.
Could be a while.
Sing song. Does that count as two words?
Hey, you get to carry on.
Okay, cool. I get it. Good. So sing song.
Moana.
Hamilton.
I mean, sing song. Walt. Sing song, Walt.
Aladdin.
Ooh. A Brave New, a Whole New World, not Brave New World.
Aladdin, Cinderella.
Things, I'm trying to think.
Sing Mulan. Song,
Everybody song, wants to be a cat.
Smile, Sing Song, Smile Walt. That's probably a better order.
Sing Song, Smile Walt.
Oh, I just realized I could say this as well. Sing Song, Sing Song, Smile Lion. Oh, that's two syllables.
That's two syllables. Right, you're done.
Lion King.
Right, Lion King.
We're at the Lion King.
Simba.
No worries, Hakuna Matata.
Yeah,
I said no worries at the same.
Oh, hang on, I got buzzed.
Damn it, you needed to buzz.
Oh, you didn't buzz. No buzz. I see a pickle.
Hakuna Matata.
Oh, points to Tommy.
Buzz. I didn't say shit out loud. Directly
he was. Yeah, the only reason I saw, yeah, to be fair, the only reason I realized I needed to buzz was because Johnny was buzzing in. He was patiently buzzing in. He had his buzzer right there the whole time we were fumbling through that. I think he probably deserves it.
All right,
he probably deserves it.
Tell you what, we'll go back so we can get the edit. Johnny, do you want to buzz in again and get the point? I'll be honourable.
It's Anna from The Lion King.
Yeah, we'll all be like, what could it possibly be?
I don't know.
I have no idea what it could be.
I'm still not seeing a buzzer from Johnny. Oh, a buzzer from Johnny.
Hey, buzzer. Lion King.
It's a Kingdom of Time for The Lion King. Yeah.
I never would have guessed that.
Oh, it's so difficult.
All right, no worries.
It's not easy to...
It's meant to be difficult. That's why it's a quiz.
It's not difficult because it's a quiz. It's difficult because we're all fucking idiots.
That too. That doesn't hurt.
No.
Oh, man. It really doesn't help that I've lost my list of prompts.
The fact that the buzzers don't buzz makes a difference.
Right? This is making it a challenge.
Which is why I'm thinking of going back to my X-Files thing.
All right. There you go, Tommy. There's a prompt for you.
All right. Cool. Steel car.
Grand Theft Auto.
Yeah.
Points to Tommy and Lee.
Nice.
Damn, you got that.
It was too late.
Nice.
Oh, that was quite an easy one.
I was thinking of like
it's already
metal.
Literally a
I was
crime.
Thinking of steel.
Yeah, when you said steel, yeah. I thought you meant metal, and then you stopped, and I was like, "Where are you going with this?"
I was going to say Nick, but there's an American here who might not have understood what I was talking about. I was trying to be fair.
Oh, Nick yeah. Carr. Who's Nick Carr?
Yeah, I was like, who's Nick Carr?
Who's Nick Carr?
Is that one of your comedians?
Jimmy Carr.
See? Well Jimmy Carr's love. First you Jimmy the car, and then you Nick Carr.
All right, Johnny. You're up.
Okay. Blue fast blur.
Sonic. Oh, Buzz.
Pickle Rick.
Sonic.
Points to Johnny and Tommy.
I'm keeping my doorstep handy now.
Tommy hasn't got lag, though. That's another thing.
Yeah, but I'm also holding... I'm using two hands to hold an iPad, so...
Let's take one of these...
That's also why it looks like my cameraman's Michael J. Fox.
All right, I'm going to drop a prompt because I need some points desperately. Good man.
No good. No
get
good.
Mad. Hair go Hulk. Up.
Oh.
Goku being a Super Goku. Saiyan.
Dave. Points to Dave.
Hey, Arnold.
Vegeta got that one.
Vegeta did get that one. And
did you say Hey Arnold, Lee?
Hey Arnold, yeah. There are parallels.
Hey Arnold.
I'm sure if you hand it to the right person, he can find enough parallels.
Oh yeah, it's canon. Hey Arnold is canon in the Goku universe.
Yeah, it is.
What?
Yeah. Why not?
I'm gonna ask ChatGPT to find the parallels between Hey Arnold and Dragon Ball Z.
Do it.
And whilst you're doing that, here's a prompt for Leroy.
Here's a prompt for Leroy.
Mm-hmm.
Small. Man.
Ant-Man. But I got buzz in Ant-Man.
Buzzed? No. Carry on, Leroy.
I'm enjoying Small Man. Mm-hmm. Go Boom.
Mm-hmm. Big the Midget Liberation
Plan. Johnny.
Oh, I was going to say, is it Krillin getting exploded by Frieza?
It is not.
Okay.
Okay. I'll change it.
Give the words you've given again.
Big man. No, small man.
Small man.
Yeah, small man. Go boom. Mm. Big grey ball.
Is it Luke Skywalker destroying the Death Star?
I can only see one buzzer, and that is the correct answer. Points to Dave and to Lee.
Well done.
Small man.
Small man, make go boom.
Is Mark Hamill particularly small?
I mean, compared to a Death Star? Star?
Yeah.
Compared to me.
Trooper, yes, but...
compared to all of us.
I was thinking about a proper midget when you said it.
All right.
Shows where your mind is.
Johnny, have you had a second prompt yet?
Yeah, you gave me Sonic.
Okay, who hasn't had a second prompt?
Dave needs one.
Dave needs a second prompt. Plug in Dave, second prompt. Go!
Dead walk game.
Johnny!
The Walking
Whoa.
Dead.
The Last of Us.
No.
The Last of Us.
No to Pickle Rick.
Resident Evil.
Yep.
Points to Pickle Rick. Name
of zombie.
Points to Tommy.
I just figured I'd allude to The Walking Dead and let you just say
it
things.
It was a good misdirect.
It was a good misdirect.
I got my new buzzer.
Alright, I've got enough prompts for at least one more round. Do we want to go around one more time, guys? Are we having the good, happy, fun time?
Sure. I have got some parallels between Hey Arnold and Dragon Ball Z, if you want to hear it.
Yeah, read them to us whilst I just tidy up my
paper. Hey Arnold and Dragon Ball Z are two vastly different animated television series with distinct themes, settings, and target audiences. However, it is possible to draw a few loose parallels between the two. Coming of age, ensemble cast and friendships, family...
It's like every other show.
It ties in
also
with Fast and Furious.
It's they had to really like just go with the widest net for that. How do we connect Hey Arnold and Dragon Ball? Family, that'll do it.
Family.
That connects everything.
Family.
Fast and Furious cinematic universe.
All right, let's start
Fast and Furious with Hey Arnold.
This round with Tommy.
Okay. All right. Foot fan film, drug stab.
Foot fan film.
Train spotting.
Johnny.
It's Pulp Fiction.
It is Pulp Fiction. Can you be more specific?
Film. Oh, it's the when they revived Mia Wallace from.
There you go. Points to Tommy and John.
Foot fan film. It's a Tarantino movie.
Fucking only fans.
Right? Yeah.
I'm quite proud of people with that. Tarantino's got as many syllables as possible.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Foot fan film. The new movie from Foot Fan.
Alrighty, let's give you one. Fat boy, kill sad boy, mum, feed in bowl.
Bambi.
Silence of the Lambs.
I didn't hear all of the words.
Fat boy, kill sad boy, mum and dad, feed to sad boy, put in bowl.
Oh, it's Cartman feeding its, that guy's... parents to him.
Yeah,
in
it is,
chili,
isn't it?
From South Park.
Scott, whatever his name is.
Scott Tenenbaum.
It's Scott Tenenbaum chili. It's Cartman's chili con carnival. That's a point to me. That's a point to Tommy. And I am going to get rid of that prompt because we have done it. And
Asperger's.
I'm going to send this.
You're just saying Asperger's for no reason.
Can Lee get a point just for that?
Just for Asperger.
It just reminded me of the Cartman episode where he sells burgers.
It should have reminded you of the Chili Con Carnival episode. Lee, have a prompt.
Fish.
Oh, Finding Nemo.
Fish work man.
What?
Bad plum.
Plum.
Is it Aquaman eating a bad plum?
How have you got
Mario
plums
somehow?
In this at all?
Fish workman.
Trying to think. Okay.
Fish fire workman. Shark.
All right, I'll change it. Right. So fish.
Fish.
Can. Fish can. Like a fish can.
Kids. Of the 90s.
Oh, that's two syllables.
Yeah, well.
So you're done.
Keenan and Cal. Cal dropped the screw in the tuna.
Hold on.
Dave buzzed,
and he said the words. Points to Lee and points to Dave. Where's Dave gone? There's Dave. Right, cool.
It was that two-syllable word that gave it away, but...
Yeah, bad Leroy, but, you know...
Fish can.
Fish can.
Why not just screw in fish can?
Because you can't use the words from the actual prompt. Screw was...
Oh, screw, yeah.
Because it's tuna, isn't it?
Nut. Nut in fish can.
You could, yeah.
Me nut in fish can.
That's why you're not allowed back at the aquarium.
Nut in fish can.
That's why you no longer make sandwiches because he nuts in the fish can.
Who needs a third prompt?
Just where I got fired by SeaWorld.
Done Tommy, we've done Lee. Let's do Johnny. I'll just go around that way.
That's why I got hired by SeaWorld.
Face. Boom.
You're helping restock the salmon.
Yep.
Big green
Godzilla arrives in Tokyo. Godzilla arrives in Tokyo.
Big green you didn't put it in the prompts, so I guess I can't say it. Big green teeth. Small man.
Big green teeth.
Poop.
Big green teeth, small man poop. Okay. That's
big green teeth small man poop. Scream.
Jurassic Park.
British colonialists arriving in United States and trying to communicate.
No, but no. Dave plugged it. Plug in Dave, buzzed in.
It's Jurassic Park. The poo scene in Jurassic Park.
It is.
There it is.
Oh, nice.
I don't think I've seen that.
I don't remember.
You've never seen Jurassic Park? You've never
seen. I was just trying to think of like Tyrannosaurus when he.
I pretty much got that entire thing from the word. Poo.
Yeah.
You could have just said poo.
Johnny. All right. Prompt. Pace. Go.
Shit.
Yeah, I'm not gonna allow that.
That's not part of it. That's not part of it. I almost just read it.
Begins with E.
Everything everywhere all at once.
Space boy bike.
E.T.
E.T.
I see a Johnny first.
Whoever said that. Yeah. Specifically, I'm imagining the scene when they jump in front of the moon.
That would be the prompt.
Yeah. I got to bike and was like, I can't say jump and I can't
space
say
boy,
moon.
Space boy bike.
Cheese? Cheese hop.
So I think that just leaves Artex, right?
Yep, worst one at it. Let's go.
I'm amazed at how wide your eyes went there. Oh shit. I've got to do things.
I can't give him that go.
Stop trying to eat my food.
Well, I've only ever seen these once each, so I don't remember what this is. So you might want to give me another one because I don't know how to explain this at all.
You can try to explain the sentence.
There you go.
Well, I could. I mean, I'll give it a go. I kind of sort of recognize it.
Three more words.
Yeah, I'll just keep saying one syllable words until someone gets it.
That's the point of the game.
Okay, hold on. Actually, wait. I might be making it a bit easier. So, a scene in. I feel like I'm cheating in this, but a scene in a film.
Ah. Sure. Allowed. All single syllables so far.
Luke, I am your father.
Yeah. No. A scene in a film.
Taxi driver.
With. Orcs. As.
I see a pickle Rick.
Lord of the Rings.
Yes. Oh, well, I mean, yeah.
What's the scene?
Yeah, what's the scene?
The Battle of Tanzania.
Helm's Deep.
It is Helm's Deep. There we go. Let's move on. Points to Tex, points to Tommy.
I think I did quite well because we're in like in a film.
A scene in a film with orcs.
And it's the Battle of Helm's Deep, apparently.
It is the Battle of Helm's Deep. That's as specific as I'm going to try and make Tex get.
Okay, that's probably the first one that comes to anyone's mind.
Pretty much.
But that's why, like, the prompts had to be like the obvious stuff. Like, the only one left was the prompt left was Joker. Do you want to know how I got these scars? But I thought that was a bit too specific. All right, let
Brown
me.
Knife mouth.
Joke. Tail. Joke man asks.
How did you get these scars? Points to Pyro and Johnny. Yay! So at the end of our first game, I have 5 points. Tommy, however, has 10 points. Johnny has 7. Leroy has 4. Artex has 2. And Plug-in Dave is sitting pretty on 8.
And we're back!
We're back.
We are back. All right. The second game is called Your Attention for a Minute, Please. I'm going to give you a topic. And you need to talk on that topic for 1 minute without any hesitation, deviation, or repetition. If you hesitate, deviate, or repeat, the other people get to buzz in and steal your topic. And whoever's talking on that topic at the end of the minute gets 10 points. 5 points.
Huh, intriguing game.
5's too many.
All right.
So to demonstrate and articulate beautifully to us how this game's going to work, Johnny's going to go first.
Yay!
And Johnny's topic is why Batman is the best superhero.
Are you son of a...
Son of a bat.
He knows all of the things that we hate. This is going to be horrible.
So there's this character, and hesitation. Right?
Okay.
Hold on, hold on.
When you were explaining it, I was opening up Paint, and your audio went spotty for me, so I didn't quite catch all of the rules.
Yeah, see, so there you go. I'm fine.
All right, so. You're given a topic. You have 1 minute to talk on that topic without hesitation, deviation, or repetition. If the person talking hesitates, deviates, or repetitates, you buzz in, you make a challenge. Your challenge is correct, you take over. Whoever's talking at the end of the minutes gets the points.
Are we allowed to mention the prompts?
Yes, you can use the words from the prompt as many times as you like, but you can't repeat any other word.
So if it's about Batman, you can just go Batman.
Can you say Batman's name multiple times? Like if you say Batman is great because of XYZ and then later on you want to say his name again.
Yeah.
Say his name again.
So the words that are in the prompt that you get, you can use those words as many times as you want. And some of these prompts are shorter than others. So Johnny's prompt is why
you
Batman.
You can't use any other words.
You can use other words, but if you repeat the words, you'll get challenged.
Is the greatest superhero because he has the best rogues gallery in comic book history. For Batman's entire 80 plus years as a superhero, he has culminated a massive number of villains, some of which include the Joker, who is his greatest arch enemy and greatest rival, including other villains like
Petition,
Harley Quinn.
Villain, right, sick. So I got 30 seconds to explain why Batman is the greatest superhero ever. Batman is the greatest superhero ever because he's got bare money and lots of gadgets, but he hasn't actually got any powers. He does what he does when he does what he does by punching villains in.
Wait,
repetition. He said does. Repetition. He said does a bunch of times.
Who's challenging me? Hold on. Who's challenging?
I'll challenge you. Batman.
Leroy,
is...
you've got 15 seconds to explain why Batman's the greatest hero ever. Go.
People think Batman's really good, but he's not. He's just a rich schmuck. Thinks he's cool.
Challenge. Hesitation. He wasn't done.
He was done. Oh, he was done.
Yeah,
it's 3 seconds.
It's
been he wasn't done holding the time.
No
so
way.
Batman's the greatest superhero ever. Minutes. Wait, points to Pyro.
No.
Points to Lee for having the strongest point, I think.
Right?
Thank you. I worked really hard on that point.
It's a democracy now.
It's definitely not. Plug in, Dave. Your prompt is the MCU.
Once upon a time, there was a man named Kevin Feige, and he said, I'm going to get hold of the rights to these things that are called superheroes, and I'm going to do a bunch of movies. And he tried for a while, and he made a bunch of movies, such as the X-Men and things. True.
All right, okay, Johnny, you have 35 seconds to talk on the MCU, starting now.
The MCU begins with a film called Iron Man, where a man named Tony Stark... Wait, sorry, I said man twice, so you
hesitation.
Got it.
Hesitation. All right.
I said man twice anyway.
You thought you repeated yourself, and then you hesitated.
Yeah.
You can...
Double whammy.
All right. I got 20 seconds to talk on the MCU. The MCU
hesitation.
Is a very long sentence.
He got you. You're laughing now.
No,
you're out.
Now
you're
I'm
out.
Going. I'm out. Screw it.
For me.
Dave, you got 15 seconds to talk on the MCU. Go.
They're really good movies, except for the later ones, because everyone hates them unless it's become one of these big political things where people, some people hate them because they're too woke. Some people hate them because they're too...
Okay. Hold on. Stop. Who busted in first? I'm going to say Johnny. Johnny, you have 10 seconds to talk on the MCU without hesitation, deviation, or repetition. Starting now.
The best Marvel film is Guardians of the Galaxy Volume 2 because it absolutely is a quintessential film that delivers on everything.
All right, you're done. Good. Points to Johnny. 5 points to
Johnny. I think
Johnny
wins that one.
It is the best film. Come on.
Ragnarok.
Is that really on topic, though? Because I just kind of diverted it to saying which I thought was the best, but I guess it's a broad stroke MCU. Yeah,
it's in the MCU, and
he only said MCU, go. Yeah.
Jesus Christ, so many things, so little time. Tommy, your topic is the Disney animated classics.
Hold on,
mofo. You have 1 minute, starting now.
The Disney animated classics go back to the 1930s with the release of Snow White, which was the first full-length animated feature film, although the Disney classics can include the previous shorts that existed. So, for example, famous things like Steamboat Willie would be in there. Given Disney's broad expansion over the years, the definition of the classic has changed somewhat. There is quite a lot of cool for the Star Wars films to now be added to that because they were made at around the same time as a lot of the classic Disney canon. Before some
hesitation.
I was
also,
just about
he's like the word classic like four times.
It's classic in the prompt.
So Disney classics are in the prompt. MCU's harder, the prompt's shorter.
Yeah.
MCU, but... okay, so I have 25 seconds to talk on Disney classics.
I feel sure to. Really? I was hoping for that.
Yeah, because
you know
that
Snow White was Hitler's favourite movie?
I did not, but I don't know if I can talk about that.
That's
really
surprising.
The Disney classics started a long time ago with Snow White and had a whole bunch of movies that are on video and DVD. I have a lot of them over there. There's The Lion King. There's Aladdin. There is.
Does this count as repetition?
Films. Oh,
just listing movies.
Also, there is
listing things.
There is. No. I'll take repetition on there is. Dave, you have 15 seconds to talk on Disney classics, starting now.
The Lion King is a movie where there are a bunch of big cats. There are also a number of birds.
There are.
Once upon a time.
There are.
You're not allowed to say there are. God damn it.
Apparently.
Repetition, bro. I think Johnny's going to win this game because, Johnny, you have 5 seconds to talk about Disney classics. Starting now.
Hesitation.
One of the greatest No. I have to wait for him to say starting now. One of the greatest moments in casting was Robin Williams as the genie in Aladdin because of his improvisational skills to make jokes and make the entire animated sequence better than anything else that has ever been created in the entire Disney franchise. There you go.
There you go.
No hesitation, because I have to wait for him to say start.
That's fair. I lie. You can't just cut someone off by just yelling hesitation.
Hey, ye.
And you know what? That just for that, Leroy, your prompt is Star Wars.
I object.
I object.
Leroy, you have 1 minute to talk about Star Wars. Starting now.
Star Wars is split into a large...
that's hesitation.
I don't have to talk about Star Wars anymore, so I win.
That's Lee's tactic. I'll just hesitate until someone calls me out of it. Johnny, I guess you have 52 seconds to talk about Star Wars starting now.
Star Wars is a story about a farm boy who goes on an adventure to fight an evil empire, and along the way, he learns about the abilities of the Force by using a laser sword to battle his way across the galaxy. And
does it have to be true? No,
everyone was listening. We're all
like, what's he talking about?
talk
about Star Wars.
Sounds incredible. Do the things we say have to be true?
I mean, it kind of helps, because if it's not true, you'd be done for deviation.
Yeah.
So if you're like, oh, Star Wars is about hot dogs, deviation for the shit.
Yeah, Star Wars is great, but Superman.
I guess I've got 30 seconds to start talking about Star Wars starting now.
New pirate.
A long time ago in a galaxy far, far away.
far.
Yeah.
That's good. We should let him keep going for that.
No way. I thought about using that phrase too, and I was like, no,
you know what, Johnny?
I'll
allow it. You've got 20 seconds to start talking about Star Wars without repeating any of the stuff you've already said, starting now.
So one of the things that I always wanted to really dive deep into is, who was it that built the Death Star? Now, there must have been contractors that came in to help build...
Hesitation. I'll give it to Artex. You have 5 seconds to talk about Star Wars without hesitation, deviation, or repetition, starting now.
The Death Star was originally meant to be part of the Confederacy of the Independent Systems with Count Dooku
and Emperor Palpatine. Well done, buddy.
I usually read the wiki.
You should get an extra point for being able to answer the previous question.
Exactly.
You should get an extra point for having Wikipedia open.
Nah.
Dang it, I should have thought of that.
Don't need no Wikipedia.
All right, so who's left? Who needs a prompt?
I think it's just me. I might be
just Artex hasn't started one yet.
Tommy, I've started.
I had Disney.
You had Disney. Okay, so it's me. So it's me and Tex.
Yeah.
Artex, you have Transformers.
Ooh. Okay.
That's how I felt about Star Wars.
Yeah, I do. My knowledge. Okay,
he's done this all on purpose because I just fucking hate Disney.
You know what, man? I really wanted to give you the MCU because of your MCU burnout.
I fucking hate the MCU. I'm close to it.
Artex, you have 1 minute to talk about Transformers without deviation, repetition, or hesitation, starting now.
In Transformers, they live on another planet, which is not Earth. They can transform into vehicles, or they can come in their other form.
Repetition?
I'll allow it. Johnny, you have 45 seconds to talk about Transformers without hesitation, deviation, or repetition, starting.
Why do I do that to you guys? I always end up with so much more time.
This is deviation.
That is deviation. Tommy, you have 40 seconds.
That's fair.
No hesitation or deviation or repetition, starting now.
In any well-equipped municipal electricity grid, it's very important that you have transformers spread over the entire area of the town or city in question. The reason that these are needed is to prevent power surges and to make sure that when there is appropriate extra...
Come on!
That is definitely hesitation. But who goes in first? Johnny, you've got enough points. I've got 15 seconds.
What?
You can have it. Johnny, you got 15 seconds to talk about Transformers without hesitation, deviation, or repetition, starting now.
Transformers are robots in disguise, and everybody knows that even though Optimus's death in the 1986 film starring Orson Welles... You didn't say anything about spoilers, and you interrupted me, so that's not fair.
Deviation! He's changed the subject! He's talking about... fair, I don't want to talk about Transformers, so keep going.
You're a sabotage!
I did nothing. You know what? I'm going to allow it. Dave, you have 1 second to talk about Transformers.
Don't hesitate. Don't mess it up.
You look right. The role that was played by...
I guess I'll talk about Transformers.
I launched in with the word Unicron. That's the opposite of hesitation.
He said Unicron.
I'm taking
Well, because he hadn't said start yet. I had to wait for him to say start. So I said you, then he said start. Then I went Unicron.
I say we give Dave the point.
You know what? I'll give Dave some pity points as well. Dave, everyone has points.
Unicron.
Points for both of us, because I'm a generous and benevolent host, which leaves me with the task of talking about Saturday morning cartoons. I can't even say it, so this isn't going to end well for me.
You don't know anything about those.
I mean, without deviation, repetition, or hesitation. Harder than it sounds, man. Come on. We've been here all day. My minute starts now. Once upon a time, a long time ago, when I was a small boy, at the weekends, we would turn on our television.
Sorry, repetition. You said time twice.
Did I? Well, fuck
me. I just wanted to stop you, so...
All right. Okay, well, then you've got 50 seconds to talk about Saturday morning cartoons. Starting now.
The best way to watch any Saturday morning cartoons is getting a bowl of cereal. Your favorite cereal, mine is Cinnamon Toast Crunch.
Deviation.
I'll take deviation on that.
That's Saturday morning cartoons. There's no deviations to that. That
you changed it to be about
Saturday
cereal.
He's not yakking about Captain Crunch.
Sorry. That's not how that works. What?
Thomas, you have 42 seconds.
You're going to get
talk about Saturday morning cartoons. Starting now.
The animated mascot, Tony the Tiger, is the quintessential icon.
That's cereal, that's not cartoon.
Johnny's right. Johnny, I've heard 5 seconds to talk about Saturday morning cartoons. No deviation, repetition, or hesitation.
How much? I'm sorry, how much time?
35
I think
seconds.
We all lose a point if no one talks about cartoons.
I think we should make it all about not cartoons.
Go.
The reason why we watch Saturday morning cartoons is so that when we watch the commercials, we can see the toys, and the toys are what we buy so that we can play the adventures of what we've seen in the cartoons. Now, the best cartoon of the time was Thundercats. Thundercats was awesome because it had these groups of people who were cat people, and you guys have missed so many of these repetitions.
Right, I got 13 seconds to talk about Saturday morning cartoons starting now. As a young lad, I liked nothing more than to go down in the morning and turn on my TV.
Repetition, this is the same
TV.
Thing he started Deviation. Saying before. this is the same story from before.
Hesitation, you lose.
Hesitation, I lose.
The whole thing's repetition.
Can we give Lee some points for the incredible Thundercat drawing?
There is an incredible Thundercat drawing.
Yeah, it's awesome.
Who called me? I don't care if it's valid or not. Who called me?
It was Dave.
Dave, you got 10 seconds to talk about Saturday morning cartoons starting now.
Dexter's Lab had an episode where Dexter wanted to learn French, so he got this tape and he put it on his ears over the night and slept, and it kept telling him. It got stuck on this one thing. It kept saying the phrase, omelette du fromage, over again.
Time's up. Point to Dave.
Oh,
all right. And that brings us to the end of the round. And at the end of that round, points are all over the place. Dave is somehow in the lead with 18 points.
Nice.
Johnny is 1 point behind on 17. I am two points behind that on 15. Lee, you're on 4. Tex, you're on 7. Tommy, you're on 10.
Nice. I've stayed in exactly the same place.
You have stayed in exactly the same place.
So I'm on 4 points. So I'm losing.
You are losing. That
okay,
is,
cool.
That's the thing I can confirm.
That's just where I want to be.
Right, what else could we play without...
I need to mosey.
You need to mosey.
Right, so this has been an experience. Now that we know how thick shit works, next time round, we'll be better.
All right, cool.
Absolutely.
Catch you later, everyone. Lee, do you want my points?
Yeah.
Cool, Lee, do you want my points?
Lee's up to 14.
Yeah. That's not the rules.
You know what? Oh, perfect. Perfect.
Cool. Johnny, nice to meet you. Fucking everyone else, I'll see you around, I'm sure.
14.
5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Out. Later, bye. Right, let's pause the recording. Bye. I let go of Tommy.
Yeah.
Oh, shit.
Oh, yeah, no, of course.
I won't draw a single
we're back. Screen share. Share audio. Share. No peni. All right. If I've set this up right, which I might have done and I might not have done, our next game is guess the song from the pop culture thing with the thing. So I'm going to play a song for up to 10 seconds. You're going to buzz in. The quicker you buzz in, the more points you get. You get it?
Buzz.
All right, nonsense out. We have a game. We're going to play the game. Are you ready for your first clue?
Ready to rumble.
Was that a hint?
Craig, it's going to be different living out here. Don't let your uncle or your cousin get you into any kind of shit. Now, you hear me? Pop some gum.
Boondocks.
I see a Johnny first.
The next Friday.
Ooh, I'll accept next Friday. And that was within 9 seconds. So you can have... Where the frack did I put my pen? You can have a number of points that I will decide that is not arbitrary at all.
I don't get it.
What don't you... Who doesn't get what?
No, I just didn't know what the song was.
Well,
yeah, see, are we guessing the song? We're guessing the movie, right?
You have to guess the property that it's from. You can have a bonus point if you can name the artist and the song title as well. Yeah,
got nothing for
you. So you got nothing for me there. I will give you...
I don't really do pop culture. That's my issue.
Good thing you joined this pop culture game show.
I know. Well done, me. South Park.
Well, I saw a Johnny first, but you guys aren't like buzzing in, so I guess Johnny.
I was buzzing in. I was putting my hat on the microphone.
You know what, Dave?
What the points between me and Dave?
How are we buzzing in this time?
Visually,
the same way we've ever been buzzing in.
No. I put my hat on the microphone.
All right, Dave, give me a correct answer, and you can have some points.
South Park.
Yep. Have you got a artist and a song title for us as well?
Primus. Don't know the name of the song. That South is correct. Theme,
that is all correct. You did it in 5 seconds. You can have 10 points. Oh. 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 2, 3, 4. All right. Sick.
Lee,
get ready for your next.
Your head straight away.
Your next. Yeah. Move for your chicken. Johnny.
You got the touch by Stan Bush from Transformers 1986.
That is all the points in under 5 seconds. That's 50. 10 points.
That was like 1 second.
I was going to say 15 is quite a lot.
Yeah, you can have 10.
It's not as good as Dare. Dare is a better song, but that's okay.
Yeah, but it's less like well known.
It's Dare.
Yeah.
It's Dare.
Shit.
That's your 10 seconds. Johnny.
Sorry, I got nothing.
Is it like a reality game show?
It was not a reality game show.
You never guess. Are you saying it's from Beetlejuice?
I'm not saying it's from Beetlejuice. Okay. I see a chicken from Leroy.
Go on, Lee.
Leroy.
No.
Leroy offers no answers.
No.
It was Cuban Pete by Jim Carrey from The Mask.
Oh yeah. That's my first thought, but yeah. That's okay, good.
Oh, it can be songs that turn up at any point. I've been thinking.
Johnny!
The Ghostbusters theme.
Just about to say that, damn it.
It's the Ghostbusters theme. 6 seconds, I don't know, 6 points. 1, 2, 3, 4. These points are totally arbitrary. I'm giving your points to Tommy. Johnny's there.
That's super arbitrary.
I know what's up.
That's the most arbitrary thing that's happened so far. Apart from when Tommy gave all his points to Lee.
That's the only reason I'm where I'm at.
Apparently this has a silence at the beginning. So, starting now.
Oh, I know what it is. It's Peacemaker.
I saw a storm. I see the stormtrooper.
It is the intro to Peacemaker.
But,
is it? You want to taste it by Wigwam?
Tell you what, I'll give.
I wouldn't have got the name.
I'll give basic points to Dave, and I'll give full points to Johnny.
I'm happy with that.
Johnny. All right.
Go,
six.
Go.
All right. I see you, Johnny.
It's the Bond theme, or it's the theme from GoldenEye.
It is.
Huh. Yes, I don't remember who did the song though.
That's fair enough. You were at the under the 5 second mark. You can have 10 points for that. All right, sick.
Who did the theme from GoldenEye? No.
Oh, it's Tina Turner.
Oh, it was Tina Turner.
Wait a sec.
Best in peace.
Hold on. You were saying, Dave?
We could buzz in by drawing.
That takes too long to show up.
Yeah. No worries.
I think the silent buzz in works because he's going to see. He's going to look to see.
Yeah, because I'm looking.
And he calls who, does the buzz.
Okay.
All right, you're next. This is like the smoothest game so far. I see a wavy hand from Artex. Is that you buzzing in?
No, I just clicked it. It wasn't me.
I see it.
Take a stab.
I see a shaky.
I have a prompt for that.
Oh, go on, Tex. Since you're talking.
No, I don't know what it was.
Is that a head from Johnny? Johnny.
Yeah, is it the theme from Jurassic Park?
It is the theme from Jurassic Park.
No. Well, is that a specific Jurassic Park? I always think of the.
It gets there.
It's not in the first 10 seconds.
Yeah, I couldn't quite. Okay. I wasn't sure because it wasn't a clear audio, but yeah.
Oh, right. Okay.
Johnny.
Is it the theme from Godfather?
It is the theme from Godfather.
Yeah, I feel like you'd have to watch these things more than once to be able to know.
I don't know about that. Yeah. It's a pretty classic theme.
Yeah, it is. Do you want to go for the bonus points?
I don't know who composed it.
That was Henry Mancini.
Oh, of course it was.
I'm less good at that part, but I can recognize it.
Guys, you all specifically have a chance to make up here, because if Johnny gets this one, I'm giving him like bare bonus points, because I don't even know if this show made it across the pond. See you, Dave.
I don't remember if this is what it is, but Biker Grove?
It's not Biker Grove.
Is it Mambo number 5?
It's not Mambo number 5.
It's the one with the prefects, right? The one with the is it?
Wait.
Oh, I see a Johnny.
Is it Red Dwarf?
It's not Red Dwarf.
Okay, then I don't know.
Is it Green Elf?
Leroy.
Is it Robot Wars?
It's not Robot Wars. You guys might be too young for this.
Headmaster.
I might be showing my age with this.
What? Dora, okay, before you tell us what it is, what year did it come out?
Like 90s?
Google it.
Alright.
And then without saying what
it
is.
But you're saying
it's also specifically a show in the UK, like a UK show.
I don't think you guys got it in the States.
Yeah.
Or if you did, you got like the repeat syndication later, or there's your own hokey American version.
Is it the Demon Headmaster?
It's not.
It's the only thing I feel like I really recognise the song.
1990 is when it debuted.
I wasn't even born, man.
Yeah, but TV was slower when you were a child. All right,
even when I was like three years old, I was still...
What was it?
You guys aren't going to get it, so we'll move on with our lives. It was.
Did you say what it was, though?
Let me fucking speak! It was the theme of Christmas Maze.
Crystal Maze. Yeah, I have no idea what that is.
Never heard of that. You never heard of Crystal Maze? All right, moving on.
Did a reboot of it with Richard Ayoade.
Yeah, he did.
Still
had the same theme song. All right.
I don't have TV, mate.
I see you, Johnny.
Julio Gangster's Paradise?
That is the name of the song and the artist, but what's the property that's from?
That's what
you want.
Oh, yeah.
It's from the Michelle Pfeiffer movie that I cannot fucking name right now. Sorry.
Oh, I'm afraid that I can't accept that as an answer. I see Leroy choking a chicken.
Valley of Death.
Thanks, Leroy. Thanks for
that. That is not an answer that I can accept. Anyone else want to chime in on this?
Through the Valley of Death.
I'm no expert, but Valley of Death?
Valley of Death is not a TV show.
I think it's like teacher or something. It's an education or something.
You're so on the nail. You just
yeah.
I will put you guys out of your misery. It was Dangerous Minds.
Yeah, there you go. Wouldn't have come up with that.
All right.
I feel like the song was more famous than the show.
Yeah. And that's, I know the song, but I've never heard.
That's why it's like a quiz. Like, it's difficult. It's not as easy. Yeah. Not quite as easy. Yes, perhaps
on that.
Perhaps as no. You get no points because you didn't get the property.
Damn it.
But so property first, bonus points for song and artist after.
Got it.
Right. So next prompt.
Is it Umbrella Academy?
It is Umbrella Academy.
Oh, nice.
What's Umbrella Academy?
It's a TV show on the Netflix that came out within the last 2 years, so you can't claim you're too young for that one. No. Artex, by any chance, can you tell us the name of the composer or the name of the film?
I can.
Go on.
Not tell you any of it.
Ah, well, you can have 5 points for Umbrella Academy.
Was it Gerard Way?
He wrote the comic.
I was just wondering if he did the theme song.
No, Jeff Russo did the theme song, and it's called Under the Umbrella. Okay. Johnny.
This is from No Cure for Cancer, Dennis Leary, I'm an Asshole.
That is all of the correct answers, and that is a full fledgling. I'm running out of room to write your points, Johnny. You might have
won. That's right.
Rigged.
Nothing. I'm over here all the way to another continent.
All right. Super easy. Here we go. I see a Dave first.
Scrubs.
It is Scrubs.
I'm No Superman.
That is also correct. Do you know the artist?
Jimmy McScrubs.
Yeah, not so
much. I'll give you one of the bonus points. Scrubs. It was by Laszlo Bain. I'll give you a good amount of points.
But the song is called I'm No Superman.
It is called I'm No Superman. So you get the bonus point for that. So you get...
Scrubs the same as How I Met Your Mother.
No. Yes, exactly the same, Lee.
Almost exactly the same.
Same cast, same cinematography. Yeah.
Better ending. Yeah.
You could end one episode and start another episode of the same. It would be like you're watching the same show.
Yeah.
You'd never notice.
Right, I've probably seen it then.
Yeah, absolutely.
Yeah. Doctor Who.
I know what it is.
That's your 10 seconds.
Oh, it's...
I'm gonna give Leroy chicken. Go for it.
What? Did my thing come up slow or something? Oh.
The chicken was what I saw move first. Leroy, what you got?
I forgot.
Oh, in that case, Dave.
San Andreas. GTA San Andreas. Can't name the title of the
computer. Is it the Grove Street theme?
It's just down as theme from San Andreas.
Oh, okay. Good call.
That one's too niche.
That remake was the worst thing I ever played start to finish.
Johnny.
Is it Justice League Unlimited?
It is Justice League Unlimited.
Yeah.
Do you want to go?
Like backing music from Bill and Ted for a second.
Danny Elfman, I have no idea. I don't know.
It's not. It is. I've got to wait for it to scroll back round right now, so I can tell you who it is. It is Michael McCustian.
Yeah.
And someone and the guitarist.
I have no idea. Yeah.
Okay.
That's why I was thinking of Bill and Ted. Bill and Ted.
Bill and Ted.
That's all the time you get.
What are those noises going?
Yeah, they're
the
whales dolphins?
Being attacked.
Was this Sequest?
space dolphin.
I see a Leroy.
Is it the movie about Flipper the Dolphin?
It's not a movie about Flipper the Dolphin. No. I see a Dave.
No, I was just scratching my shoulder.
Oh, he's just scratching his shoulder.
I still me then. Is it Moby Dick?
It's not Moby Dick. It's nothing to do with fish.
The one. Oh, okay.
I think this game should be, can we guess it before Lee Shazams it?
I mean, if he's been Shazamming it, he hasn't been doing well. Because at the moment, that's
what I mean.
This is my Shazam chicken.
Country Mile, Johnny and Dave.
That's why he needs Shazam. That's the test. No, it's a handicap. All right.
Here's your next one. In 2, 1. Wait. Oh yeah, I need to tell you what that last one was. It was RoboCop.
That was RoboCop?
It was RoboCop.
Wow. Well, shoot.
I see you, Johnny. Yeah.
It's the Rocky theme by Bill Conti.
I'll accept it, but according to my album here, it's just the Rocky
Gonna
Orchestra.
Fly now? Oh, okay.
The Rocky Orchestra. But yeah, you can have full points for that.
It's Bill Conti. We know it's Bill Conti.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Too many points. Too many points. I don't know. Oh, you guys aren't going to get that. You're not getting the more niche.
No, do the more niche ones.
All right, have the more niche. Leroy.
Noddy.
It's not Noddy.
If that was the theme song for Noddy, that would be the greatest.
The theme song for Noddy, I'd watch it.
It would be the most pimped out Noddy show ever. He'd be driving around in a lowrider.
You can have 2 more seconds of it.
I'm just thinking of Noddy now.
That was a long 2 seconds. You guys are stopping, aren't you?
That is
low
the problem. But
Noddy.
When
it's
you
not low riding Noddy, I'm going to
a bunch of things. There's a bit of delay in response.
It's got a funk to it, so I'm trying to think of. It's not like Starsky and Hutch, is it?
It's not. Okay.
I got nothing.
I'm seeing deadpan faces, so I will put you out of your misery by telling you that it is the closing theme to Samurai X: Rurouni Kenshin.
That's why I didn't.
Yeah, I was looking for pop culture.
I have no earthly idea what any of those words in order are.
Yep. Yeah,
don't make me Google how good a franchise that is. instead, tell me what this is.
Imagine if Google comes back and says it's not.
Johnny.
It's Bittersweet Symphony.
Uh-huh.
Are you asking me what movie or TV show from that's from? Because like you could name a bajillion of them. That's just
this is
silly.
How I felt about Coolio.
Yeah,
but it specifically came from one soundtrack primarily, and so did this.
Did it?
Yes, it did.
I mean, I get the Coolio when they had a whole music video about it.
Yeah, and so did this.
Did
it? Guess.
It
I'm
did.
Was it City of Angels?
It was not. You're in the wrong country.
I've got a guess.
I'm in the correct country, thank you very much.
Dave has a guess.
Is it Trainspotting?
It is Trainspotting.
Oh, hey. Well done.
Yes. You know what, Dave? You can have a bunch of points for that.
Sweet.
For countryman bias. and to try and close the gap between you and Johnny and create a false sense of competition.
Okay.
Hey, we're doing well, Artex.
Yeah, we're doing great.
I reckon we should be one entity on this moment.
You know what?
Yeah.
The way the cameras are set up, it almost is like
it almost is. You know what? I'm joining you two together, and you're still behind Johnny.
If Artex stands up, he'll look like Lee's body.
So Lee Tex, you've got Lee more points. we've had The Godfather. Oh, okay. If you need, if any of you need 10 seconds on this one, I'm defriending you immediately.
I saw
Johnny first.
I mean, it's Fresh Prince.
Of course she did.
I don't even see Johnny on the screen right now.
You're so fast.
It's
I
Fresh
know
Prince
I have
Bel Air.
It's the theme. Will Smith.
There you go. Those are the collections of words I'm looking for.
Boy, I don't leave my buzzer in the room.
I'm having a bad day.
It's about time that I get my Tex.
Despicable Me.
It is Despicable Me. Do you want to give us the name of the song and the artist?
I think the name of the song is actually called Despicable Me.
That is correct. Ooh, and you did it in a good amount
well
of time
done, Tex.
To give Lee Tex more points.
We got some points,
like,
Tex.
Let go of my thingy. I was trying to wave it. But I was like, ugh.
Just like that.
All right, I'm going to have to concentrate hard to see who moves quickest on this one, because this is super...
Thank you.
Johnny.
That Superman theme by John Williams.
That is correct, sir.
That's probably why I didn't know it.
Star Trek.
Superheroes.
Superman's not my jam.
No. I mean, could you imagine Superman jam?
Yeah.
Oh, wait. Interesting.
It would be made of kryptonite.
It'll be hot when you look at it, but cold when you breathe on it.
Hmm.
That's pretty close between Lee and Johnny. I'm gonna offer it to Lee.
I was gonna say James Bond.
That is correct.
I'm not going specific, I'm just gonna say James Bond.
Take the Lee Tex James Bond points.
Okay.
I'm glad I didn't get caught because I was thinking about Mission Impossible.
I see a Johnny.
Oh, what
Spy Break from the Matrix.
That is correct. Do you want to get? Do you have the artist as well for that additional?
Was it the Crystal Method?
It was not. It was the Propeller Heads.
The Propeller Head. That's right. Sorry.
Crystal Methods.
Crystal Method.
Listen, I got a Spy Break from Matrix. That was.
I don't know. I've never seen Matrix.
Leroy, I'm trying to help you out here.
I feel like Crystal Method would have named themselves that on purpose so that you could make that joke. But...
Probably.
All right.
Who they are, but probably.
Whoever did that song. Oh, I feel like it's right there, but.
Oh.
Leroy.
No.
I was going to say Aliens because it sounded alien, and then that happened.
I would love it if that was a theme song for Alien. Can you imagine the opening credits of Alien with that coming in, when the eerie text is coming in?
Maybe I should
I'll
start
give it again from the beginning.
Assigning soundtracks.
From the beginning, from the top, because you can't have it much further past that prompt because it will just tell you what it is.
I'm just thinking of Aliens now.
Yes, is that me?
I guess it's Johnny.
Go.
It's the Sailor Moon theme.
It is the Sailor Moon theme.
Yeah.
See, what is a Sailor Moon?
You named your cat after the cat from Sailor Moon, and you don't know.
No, I did not because I don't know what it is. My cat's called Luna because she's a black cat with a little white spot that she looks like a star. It's not my fault.
It's the cat from Sailor Moon. You literally you got yourself the cat from Sailor Moon, and Dave's floating around in space.
But I didn't know it. That's like someone buying a big furry costume and you being like, wow, it's the Wookiee from Star Wars. You're so original.
Yeah, why would you buy a Wookiee from Star Wars outfit if you don't know what Wookiees or Star Wars are, bro?
I don't know.
Is a Wookiee a bear?
Yeah, exactly.
Is a Wookiee a bear?
I don't know. I'm going to shut this conversation down with one of these.
Ewok more bears.
I'll just quote him for a line.
Was our text just dancing or was he buzzing in?
I was just dancing.
Oh, in that case, I guess it's Johnny's Stormtrooper head.
Mortal Kombat theme.
It is the theme for Mortal Kombat.
I don't know who remixed it.
Good, because I've run out of space to give you points. So I guess that brings us to the end. You know what? Have I got any
more? Oh, is that the end? Oh, no.
Oh, damn it, man. We were doing so well.
We were doing so good. Hey, Dave, do you want to team up?
Let's team up.
Let's slowly form the UK coalition against Johnny. I'm not going
to
lie.
I think you're still
losing.
Probably.
So you know what? I'll allow it. Here we go. Next. I see a Johnny.
It's the Duel of Fates from Star Wars: The Phantom Menace.
I was about to get it, but he got there just. Yeah.
I was going to say Vicar.
I was about to go Fatama. I realised I should be but voting.
Kick me out.
Definitely sounded like the Vicar of Dibley. It was the right.
Vicar of Dibley would be with the Duel of the Fates. Oh my god, this is so annoying. Oh shit.
Well, that's your 10 seconds. I can't play any more than that. Johnny
did
what it is.
Johnny's
doing a thing. Johnny is doing a thing.
Is it I Am Iron Man by Sabbath?
I'll accept that. Yes. Yeah. That is correct.
Is it from
Black Sabbath? Sorry.
Do you know what it's from, or is it just you just?
I'm imagining he's pulling it from the Iron Man film.
There you go. There's the
correct answer. I was going to say Iron Giant, but
yeah, okay. I'm pretty sure that was used before that movie. But yeah.
Oh, I see an artifact.
Is it Power Rangers?
It's not.
I recommend it, but.
That bit. Oh my god. Oh!
I see it, Dave.
Yeah.
Chipmunks.
It is the Chipmunks.
Yeah, I was like, it sounded too 80s to be.
Yeah.
Okay.
I'm guessing that's the original Chipmunks.
It is. The UK coalition have gained more points.
The original ones would be.
God damn one. It!
I know the song, but I don't know what it's from. Fuck.
Well, that will help you, so I'm gonna give it. I'm gonna let Johnny offer up the answer.
I don't know who you got to as a remix, but it's the Legend of Zelda theme.
Oh, I had Pokemon. Shit. That's
well, you were definitely out. Do you want? I know it's a remix, but he's also credited as the artist because he composed it. So, can you tell me who composed the theme for Legend of Zelda?
I have no clue.
Oh, well, it was Koji Kanoda.
Yeah, I don't
know. Who?
That's
Koji Kanoda.
It's me.
Not
him. It's the guy whose friend turns into a big monster in Akira, I think.
Why not? That's what you get. Actually, that's slightly over 10 seconds.
Oh, no.
Harry Potter?
Felt like Harry Potter, but I don't think.
Sounds like it had two.
Oh, I have people stumped. I reckon if we talk a little bit more, I can play another few seconds and get away with not getting struck.
Talking a little bit more, see if he doesn't get struck.
That, if anything, that's made it worse.
Yeah, I don't know. Sorry.
Just turned into a cacophony of noise after the first couple of seconds.
I got nothing.
I'm gonna be honest. I thought the same as you, Lee. It sounded like not the main theme, but it sounded Harry Potter-y.
Yeah, it sounded like dueling wands or something. You know,
going through the bank or something.
Yeah, or like magical tree.
Let's see if I can give you a third clip. This is unprecedented.
It sounds very mysterious.
Johnny?
Is it A Nightmare Before Christmas?
It's not. But
is it Beetlejuice?
It's not.
Is it Tim Burton?
It's not.
Okay, never mind then. I got nothing.
You were closer with the music side of it.
Oh, okay.
Danny Elfman.
It's a Danny Elfman
piece. It is a Danny Elfman piece. And I reckon we're doing just about... Like, I want someone to get this. Why? And if no one gets
is
this,
is it from a Batman?
It's not from a Batman.
Oh fuck! Shit.
I don't know if you guys. Is it Courage?
It's not Courage, Dave.
Okay. Honey, I Shrunk the Kids.
It's Rocko's Modern Life. No,
Shrunk the Kids.
Cat Dog.
Cat, it's not Cat Dog.
It's that dun 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 dun. Oh shit!
Come on, Artex.
I don't know what it is, but I really like it.
It was Danny Elfman's score from Men in Black.
Yeah.
Oh, okay, sure.
Right on time.
All right.
I need to remember Honey I Shrunk the Kids because
I almost think we need categories at this point. We say film or TV or.
Yeah, I could probably break this down to film and TV, but film, TV, and video games.
Makes sense.
Aha! Hi, Mickey Mouse.
That sounds, I mean, like really old school Disney type music.
Johnny!
I'm going to go with, is it Blazing Saddles?
It's not.
Okay.
Oh, I don't know.
It's definitely not Digimon. It's
definitely not Digimon.
You know, you got Dave. Come on.
I'm going to guess. I'm going to be completely wrong. I'm going to guess.
Come on,
is
Dave.
It, like, is it in Pirates of the Caribbean? Like,
it's not.
The moment when, like, okay.
Let's see if I can give you a few more seconds without causing myself some mischief.
Oh, shit.
That's all you're getting. I'm not giving you any more than that.
I know what it is. I know what it is.
You don't need to know the name of the song.
I know what it is. I know what it is.
Dave knows the problem.
I know the song. It's from Captain America.
It is. Do you know? Oh, he knows the song, he says.
It's the Bonds. It's the Bond selling song from the montage in Captain America where he first becomes Captain America.
Do you know what that song's called?
I'm going to guess Captain America.
It's not, but you can have the point for Captain America to the UK coalition. It's called
Star Spangled Man.
No! Bonus points!
Well done.
The Star Spangled Man with a plan.
That is it. Super bonus points if you can tell me the credited artist.
I'm just going to guess. Is it Ray Charles? No, I don't know.
It's simply the Star Spangled Singers.
Oh. Yeah, that's why I didn't know that.
That's all right.
It was Usher.
One hit wonders.
I figured since you were on a roll,
one hit wonders.
You're like, if I take Star Spangled and just add Star Spangled Girls, maybe I'll get it. That's way too niche. You guys aren't getting niche. This. All right. I see it, Johnny.
Oh, I really recognize that. Shit.
Is this I Don't Want to Close My Eyes by Aerosmith from Armageddon?
That is all the correct answers that I was looking for.
Damn good, that one.
I haven't seen Armageddon. What's that about?
Nothing.
It's about Armageddon.
It's about, you know, oil drillers that save the world.
No, okay, go.
A sequel to what?
Go on, Lena.
Or as I like to call it, Armageddon.
Wonderwall.
No,
I see an Artex.
It's Rick and Morty.
It is Rick and Morty. Can you tell me the name of the song and the artist?
The song's called Goodbye Moomin.
That is correct. And the artist is?
The artist is... I'm going to go for a guess because I don't know. I swear it's someone called like Don Harrison or something.
I have a guess.
You're part of the UK coalition. I'll allow it.
Oh.
Go on, Dave. Yeah.
Jermaine Clement.
That is technically technically correct. So I'll give the UK code.
Flight of the Conchords, then.
No. What I was looking for was fart.
Of course you were.
That's what it's credited as. Characters by fart from the Rick and Morty soundtrack. UK Coalition can have some points. All right, I'm going to make this
some clapping. I'm going to
because it's popular, it's easy, and points are up for grabs. And this feels like a good place to round out. Leroy.
Oh. I mean, this is Pink Panther, isn't it?
Yes, it is the Pink Panther, isn't it, Lush?
Mm.
All right, so after that, the UK... Yeah. Hold on. 5, 10, 15, 20, 25, 30, 35, 40, 45, 50. So the UK coalition have racked up a total of 74 points between all three of you. And Johnny has 5, 10, 15, 20, 25, 30, 35, 40, 45, 50, 55, 60, 65, 70, 80, 85, 90, 95, 100, 110. So right. even with your powers combined,
cheat beat me.
You can't cheat beat Johnny.
Wait a minute.
And I couldn't even play that game.
There's there's such a huge power creep in the last round of this game.
I reckon there was cohorts.
Paul being on like 10 or what was it, 17 at most at the start.
I had 14 points after being given Tommy's points.
Yeah. They got added into that pool of 75 points.
That's right.
Like, there aren't many points next to you and Tex. You didn't get as many answers.
I feel like you just made this game for Johnny. I think that's what it was. Then you just were like, oh, I need more people for this game show of one. So,
I think that's bad. Just... I wish they'd start doing
movie. Oh, wait, what's that show with the Chaser? We should do it like that.
Yeah, that's kind of chase. What it was supposed to be, but I haven't been able to play my round, so maybe Johnny should be
the
chaser.
I don't really know
chaser.
How the chaser works, but maybe that works. Yeah. That's what that, it became
that's,
in the
that's
end.
That's kind
actually.
Of the loose idea, was that I was going to kind of go first and then set a score and you guys were going to beat it, but like, it didn't quite turn out that way. Because I can't get songs I'm playing myself, because the answers are right here. So I'll just be like, yeah, it's Pink Panther by Henry Mancini. It is on
Johnny
random.
Versus Shazam.
Oh, okay.
It is on random, but even if I play it on random, I'm just like...
Yeah.
It's Journey Sleep by DMX and Eminem. It's great, you know.
Yeah. I still think you need to do Johnny with Johnny versus Lee with Shazam.
All right. I need to eat some food, so I'm going to go.
Let's give Lee Shazam.
Let's wrap it up. Our unofficial winner and our first King of the Nerds is
me.
Johnny.
No. Yo!
You don't get to just shout in and win this time.
We'll work out the tweaks and iron out some creases and see if we can't, come back a little smoother. There's only one, like, pure topic next time, and it's just music, which I don't know if more bored or less
music.
Bored. Yeah, just music. This time is... What do you mean, what? A room full of musicians and Johnny.
Why?
People like music.
Yeah, a room full of musicians and Johnny.
Yeah, and me.
Have been quick, Johnny, learn guitar.
Go, I'm on it.
British like a roast. The P to the Y to the R to the O. He has been Artex. Say goodbye, Artex.
Artex. If I can do a quick plug-in, if you don't mind.
Yeah, go for it. Right
check
now.
Me out on the Straight Up Busters. We have a podcast on there. Type it in on YouTube. You'll find it. I do my music on Spotify. Same name as here. Thank you, Pyro, for having me on. It's been a good episode.
You are welcome. He has been plugging Dave. Say goodbye, Dave, and plug whatever you want to plug on your way out.
Hurdy dirty 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 dirty. Go to my channel if you like card games and stuff, because I make stuff on Marvel Snap. And if you like that kind of thing, do it. If not, fuck you. No, I don't mind. I don't really care.
Language.
He has been Lee Razzle Dove. Say goodbye, Lee, and do some shameless plugging on your way out of it.
Goodbye, Leroy. I've got nothing to plug. I don't really do anything anymore. I just
play music. World famous musician.
I've been sailing through your bullshit.
And, you have an album.
And he has been our winner for the week and unofficial king of the nerds, Johnny.
Did he do
Johnny.
That himself?
That,
he's got a little
that.
Banner.
Look
did he do that himself?
Look at that!
Look at
hey,
that.
King not of the right. Nerds. See you guys.
Oh, bye then.
I thought the call just ended.
We'll be back at some point.
And then everything disappeared.
Like, that was rude. It might be video games based. Might be more of this madness. I don't know. You don't know until it pops up on your screen. If you haven't done so already, like, share, comment, subscribe. That's all for right now. Until next time, I love you all. And there's not a goddamn thing you can do about it. But for right now, pie is out. Peace out. Lights out.